I've got two words for you. Solana Summer. What is it and how can you use it to your advantage? So to break down what Solana Summer is, Solana Summer is the momentum and the hype behind Solana NFTs this summer in the Northern Hemisphere. So what Solana Summer is almost like the shifting of consciousness when it comes to the NFT market. It's people coming from the ETH market and seeing the fun communities, the degen lifestyle and the degen aspect of Solana NFTs. Hey, hold up real quick. What I want you to do is I want you to head down there, hit up that subscribe button, and while you're also down there, hit up the like button. Okay, let's kick on. Now look, the reason that I think Solana NFTs are fun is there are almost zero gas fees, which is great. It also means that the pumps and dumps, the rises, the falls, all that happen quite fast, and it's almost quite sporadic. It's almost like being at a casino. Solana right now feels like ETH was when it was back in like August, September, October last year. The idea that really cool art and a team that's kind of semi-decent can really pop off, and it just does well. And the idea that it's very meme-like, it's very community-based. If the community wants to get behind something, it gets behind it and it runs. And the idea that with some volume that comes around, it can run up crazy. So what kicked off Solana Summer? In my mind, what kicked off Solana Summer was OKBears. What happened with OKBears? It had a run. It had the whole Solana community getting behind it going, OKBears. Then with the fact that OpenSea actually started to list some Solana projects, OKBears was popping up the top of the list and was creeping up higher and higher and started to do more and more volume, which then meant that all of the people that would usually spend their time on OpenSea and actually kind of looking at ETH NFTs were starting to see OKBears over and over. And then what happened is it started to kind of get people to start to consider Solana, which then meant that people were able to kind of onboard into the Solana ecosystem. Now, the fact that Ethereum has come down and the NFT market is kind of a little bit shaky and there's not too much liquidity in it because liquidity has been taken out, the idea that ETH NFT kind of users and speculators are heading over to Solana because they're starting to see it in front of their sort of feeds when it comes down to sort of Twitter and what's up on the top of the charts on OpenSea, and they're kind of dabbling in there, which means that more liquidity is coming into the Solana ecosystem, which means it's starting to push it forward more, which then propels this Solana Summer idea. Now, the second reason that I think Solana Summer is kicking off is because we've got some content creators that are absolutely killing it right now. Now, my boy Cody on Chain, I've actually DM'd with him a bunch of times. He watched some of this channel, these types of videos, like early on. I've been watching some of his content, and he's just been gaining a lot of steam and a lot of momentum. And what's happening is content creators like Cody, you've also got content creators like Jersey. Jersey, I've DM'd with Jersey a little bit. And the idea is that these content creators are almost like the figureheads when it comes down to the mouthpiece of what's happening in the Solana ecosystem, and they're becoming like sort of celebrities within the Solana ecosystem, which means that they can kind of propel the Solana narrative forward and kind of reach out and kind of have a bigger reach and a bigger output. So I think these guys making insane gains when it comes down to their personal followings is great. Then they're able to articulate those gains and what they're doing to people that may not be considering Solana and go, hey, you know what, maybe I should give it a go and give it a try, which then means you can run in. Like, look, I legitimately saw Cody do a tweet. I aped in and kind of like did a bit of a DJM play, ended up coming out one soul ahead. This is the tweet here. I literally jumped in. I did it. Why not? Bit of fun. And that's the kind of thing that I think is happening in the Solana ecosystem. The fact that we've got these people that are actually becoming big in that space, which means that they can then reach outside that space and pull people in. So I think that is also perpetuating that Solana Summer vibe. Now, I know I have missed a whole bunch of other Solana content creators, but these are two guys that I'm kind of coming across on the daily. So that's why it's top of mind on this video. So if you wanna have a bit of fun this summer and make a bit of money this summer, Solana is where it's gonna be. Solana's price is quite low in the grand scheme of things. And the idea that you can pick up some decent NFTs between one and two Sol is sort of $50 to $100, which is actually quite cheap and attainable. And the fact that there's almost no gas, that means that it's actually really attainable and you're able to kind of get in on that project. ETH NFTs are barely minting under a 0.05 anymore. So it means it's very hard and there's a higher barrier to entry, take on gas fees, and it's hard. the idea that people are able to kind of move in and move out of these projects quite fast, and they're able to kind of make a gain of one soul or lose one soul, and it's not actually terrible, it's not bad. People are able to get that taste. Now, I think this is great because it means you can almost get the casual kind of NFT experience. The person that wants to kind of dabble in it, they can do it at very low risk. The idea that they can load up sort of $500 worth of soul and actually have like 5 really good chances at some projects, even pick some stuff off the secondary market and do quite well. So that's why I think Solana Summer is going to make some people a bit of money, because they can kind of degen into some stuff that's 1 or 2 ETH. It could rise up to 3, 4, 5. They can then double their money. And the idea that someone can come into Solana Summer, Solana Spring, with around sort of $500, and they could leave at Solana Autumn with about sort of 2 or 3 thousand, I think that's good. Someone can kind of enjoy it and almost take their mind off what their day job is, what their schooling is, all of the things of life, and just kind of go, hey, what's popping on Twitter? What's popping? What's coming up? Degen into it, have a bit of fun, and make a bit of money, and the risks aren't too high, because especially if you're moving into a project that's sort of like half a soul or sort of like a 0.25 soul, it's actually next to nothing in the grand scheme of things when you look at what's happening over on ETH. Now, what am I the most excited about when it comes down to Solana Summer? What it is it's the fact that it's going to introduce a lot more people into the NFT space. Now, I know I may seem like an ETH maxi, and I do like ETH and ETH NFTs, but I have got this kind of part of me that wants the itch scratched when it comes down to what's happening on Solana. It's these fun, cool vibes where you can just go all in on something and just have a bit of fun. It's like actually being at the casino. And where Solana Summer gets me excited is people are able to get that thrill and that rush of kind of getting something for sort of one soul. It runs up to sort of 5, 6, 7. They can then 5x or 10x their money. They're able to kind of get that thrill and that excitement for a lower barrier to entry cost when it comes down to the project. What I think will happen is there will be a lot of people that will come in, guys that are kind of savvy, able to kind of read the markets, able to kind of pick up and get onto these projects early, make a large bag. Then what some of them will do is they'll start to liquidate some of their soul bag, not all of it, but liquidate some of it, and then move it over onto ETH. And then that's when we're going to onboard people. It's almost like the soul ecosystem is the training wheels. Sounds like a bad thing, but it almost seems like it's the playground. It's where it's the park football. It's where people are having some fun, building up those relationships, building up their capital. So when they have got the capital, they can then pull it down and then move into what could be considered a blue chip asset over on ETH, or they're double back and forth. Because if you've been in the ETH ecosystem for a lot, you're gonna have to spend 1 to 2 ETH on a decent project on the secondary after it's launched to actually kind of do well. Look at something like PXN. And the idea is that if you have 1 or 2 ETH worth of soul, you're going to be able to pick up a lot of like a really high quality blue chip project when it comes down to, or potential blue chip project when it comes down to the Solana ecosystem. So that is what Solana Summer is, why I think it's kicking off, and why I think it is a good thing for the NFT space overall. I think Solana Summer is for you if you're finding the ETH NFT kind of ecosystem a little bit boring and it's not moving to the speed that you want, and you're not getting what you want from it. I think Solana is the great ecosystem kind of dabble into and have a bit of a play. You don't just have to be all Solana or be all ETH. You can be a bit of both. And the idea is you can just turn on a bit of Solana, scroll on Magic Eden, scroll on OpenSea, and just kind of pick up something that is a complete degen play and scratch that itch that is having a bit of fun in the NFT space and trying to find something to flip. So if you found value in this video, please consider hitting up that subscribe button. And while you're down there, also hit up the like button. As always, it's been a pleasure having you with me. I look forward to seeing you in the next one.